Praise the Lord Jesus, believers. I'm Tanisha and welcome back to my channel. Now, I quickly wanted to share something. You know, it's more than I thought because I think it was weekend I was reading the book of Matthew, and I was reading Matthew 5, but I was really just taking my time, so I didn't just rush and read up the entire chapter because it has so many verses. Now, when I came across this particular verse in Matthew, I really begin to consider and to just look of what it is the scripture was really saying and how it is that I can use this word that was spoken then to apply in my life today, in order for me to make it in, or to be a better believer, or to serve God better, or to serve others better. And it's a very practical scripture. Like, it's a very practical scripture. We have to be very practical about it. Me personally, I've been thinking about it. And I'm saying, you know, that I cannot afford to be locked out or to be cast into utter darkness merely because I have chosen not to remove a particular sin from my life. Because you see, even in Revelation, I believe there is something over there speaking about even the very same thing. And when we really look at it, you know, there's a whole list of things. And some of us will not be guilty of some things, but some of us will be guilty of something. But now in the scripture, in the book of Matthew, it's speaking about cutting things off. And it's a very practical word. Like, I've been thinking about it. I've been thinking about how I'm going to word it. You know, personally, I believe that it is really for me. But one thing I know for sure is that anything I experience, anything I am going through, it is something that after I've grasped it, it is something that I can even share with somebody while even holding on to this very word. And so let me see if I can quickly read it. So it is Matthew 5, and I'll be reading from let me get the scripture. Matthew 5, and I'll be reading from verse 27. And then I'll stop at verse 30. So that's Matthew 5, verse 27 to 30. Ye have heard that it was said by them of old times, thou should not commit adultery. But I say unto you, that whosoever looketh on a woman to lust after her had committed adultery with her already in his heart. And if thy right eye offend thee, pluck it out, and cast it from thee, for it is profitable for thee that one of thy members should perish, and that not thy whole body should be cast into hell. And if thy right hand offend thee, cut it off, and cast it from thee, for it is profitable for thee that one of thy members should perish, and not that thine whole body should be cast into hell. It is better for one member of the body to perish than for the whole body to be cast into hell. And it's a very practical scripture. And if we are, let us look at it physically first. Like, let us look at the scripture physically first. It's spiritual go with Tanisha. Let us see if we can go. Let us see if I can teach you, if I can deposit, if I can share something while in the season of grasping and learning it at the same time. You see, my issue is that I always have to go through in order to tell you how to do it. I always believe that I have to have the experience in order to speak on it. But there is something different when you become a believer. Like, it's not always about what you experience. Your experiences are good, but there are going to be times when you will have to speak by faith, without doubt, that this is what's happening, that this is the word that you should deposit in this season for somebody else. And even so, I always believe that I must go through it. I must, have that connection with it in order to say it. But that's not always the case. Now let us look at this scripture. The Bible is saying that, if a man commits adultery, somebody commits adultery, they are a sinner. And the wages of sin is death. The wages of sin is death. Back then, even in the Old Testament, when persons sinned, they used to be stoned to death. When persons sin was revealed and person become aware of their sins, they would be stoned to death. They wouldn't have the privilege to even repent. They would have been immediately stoned to death. Now the Bible is saying that if you look at a woman, you commit adultery with her in your heart, and if thy eye offend thee, pluck it out, because it is not profitable. Or because it is profitable for thee to enter into the kingdom of heaven with one eye than to perish because of this one sin done by this one organ, that the entire body should be cast into hellfire. No, that is what it's saying. And it's saying that if thy right hand offend thee, cut it off, because it is profitable for thee that thou should enter into the kingdom of God having one hand, than because of this one hand thy whole body is cast into hellfire. Now, let us look at this spiritually now. Let us look at this emotionally. Let us look at this in a practical way without being practical. Because in today's day, if we should have plucked out our eyes and cut off our hands and our ears, we wouldn't have any organs, that there wouldn't be enough doctor to operate on us. But the Bible is simply saying that there are things that you need to do, there are things that I need to do in order to make it into the kingdom of heaven. It is better that I should put my pride, be bruised by my pride, in order to make it in. It is better if I should look beyond the shame or the embarrassment and make sure that I can make it in. Yeah, I should do that. There are things that persons hold on to, there are things that persons experience, there are things that even I have not yet fully recovered from, and I am still learning each and every day to recover from it. And this scripture is saying to me, Tanisha, you can't afford to make the experiences that you have gone through causes you to sin and be cast into hell. But you must. The one organ, the one part of the body that can cause the entire body to fall into hell, that same one part of the body, you can choose to, get it right, that one part of the body becomes a savior for the entire body. I don't know if you're getting it, but that's what I am getting. In fact, I've been working on this word. Like, I've been working on this word naturally when I'm faced with a word. And I know it's a word for the season. I know it's a word for me now. And I can't grasp it. I just leave it. I don't share it. But somehow I have this push to share it. But I don't like to share it if I don't fully understand it, because I might leave someone in a state of confusion. And we know that the Lord is not the author of confusion. And we know that whenever a believer speaks, there shouldn't be a lot of questioning, but there should be a lot of understanding. There should be a lot of faith being increased. When a believer speaks, there shouldn't be confusion. There shouldn't be an uproar. There should be a stillness. And so I don't like to speak on things that I don't fully understand because I don't want to leave anybody confused. No, I don't want to leave anybody confused. I don't want to give the person's wrong interpretation. I don't want to give persons things that they will hold on to that will cause them in the end. I don't want to do that. But the Bible is saying that there are things that you and I have to cut off. Things you will have to cut off. Things that is profitable for you to cut off in order to make it into the kingdom of heaven. There are things that you have to cut off in order to make it in the kingdom of heaven. Cut off hypocrisy. Cut off hatred. Cut off unforgiveness. Cut off everything that is contrary and is objective to your growth. You cannot allow these little things. You cannot allow these one things to cause your entire body, your entire being to go to hell. You cannot. God is all about the saving of the soul. No, we cannot allow the things that we do in this body to jeopardize our future, our faith. So we have to cut things off. We have to cut things off in order to make it into the kingdom of heaven. It is profitable for us to know the things that are affecting us and to cut them off. We're going to do it through our faith. We're going to do it through prayer. We're going to do it through fasting. We're going to do it through counseling. We're going to do it through speaking about it. We're going to do it. We're going to do it because we don't want to be cast into hell. We don't want to be cast into hell. If this video is uploaded, the Lord bless you. If it's not, I will definitely do it again. This same word, I will do it again. I'll wait 2 weeks, I'll wait 3 weeks, and then I'll do it again. But somebody needs to hear this now. Now. Abraham was trusting God. Abraham was believing God. Abraham did not know where he was going. Abraham did not know where he was going. Abraham did not get a blueprint of the path that the Lord was taking, and Abraham had to trust God, had to encourage the multitudes, and not being sure what was even going to take place. Abraham had to do it in the midst of learning it, in the midst of even having the faith for it. Many man and woman of God, those who are in the Bible, they had to do it while learning it. They had to do it while learning it. They have to teach while being taught. And this takes a great amount of obedience to do this. Because sometimes you will look silly. Sometimes you will look like a fool. Sometimes you will look unlearned. Sometimes you will sound unlearned. But you have to do it. You have to do it. It's a journey, and you have to just do it. There are things that you and I have to do, have to cut off in order. There are things that we have to do that will be profitable for us. So cut it off. So Tanisha, you have to forgive now. You have to let go now. You have to be ready to do it now. Doing it now will help you in the long run. So the Lord bless you in Jesus' name. Thanks for watching the video, guys. If this video is confusing, drop me a comment. I'll definitely do this word again because I don't know why I've been delaying on this word. I have been delaying on this word for days. I have never seen myself delayed on a word so much. And it's not that I haven't read it. I have read it. I have read it several times. I've prayed and I've applied it to my life several times. But still, I am struggling with it in order to leave a word of encouragement based on it. And yet, I can't skip over it. Sometimes, if I'm struggling with a word, if I'm struggling with a message, I'll just leave that. I'll document it and I'll leave it halfway. And then I'll just quickly go to another word. Skip the book, go to an entire new book and read and get another word. And then sometime in future, I'll just revisit that word that I have started. But this is not the case. If I sound confusing, I'm so sorry for that. But just go pick up your Bible and read it yourself. Matthew 5, reading from verse 27 to verse 30. It is profitable for us to cut things off, to remove things from our spiritual life, to remove things from our mind, to remove things from us, to cut things off that we don't enter into the kingdom of darkness, that we don't make it to hell, but we make it to heaven. There are things that we will have to do to be practical about in order to make it in. God bless you.